This shows the development of investigation equipment. There are many kinds of equipment. For example, this is suppression chamber, a bottom, a magnet is used for robot, and also a vent pipe, dry well joint. This is very narrow space, so this can go into that narrow area. So this is what we are developing now. So conducting such experiment, this is an IRID member manufacturer. Factory is making a mock-up like this so that we can verify whether robots are functional. And also, there are other types of robots being developed. One is a horizontal floor removing equipment. This is on the side of torus room. In order to see that, this is at the bottom of torus. This robot runs there. And also, underwater swimming equipment, and also suppression chamber top area. This is estimated. There is a leakage there. So a vertical moving robot is being and also dry wall outside. We have pipes there, and the robot will be used to investigate that area as well. Development is now underway. And also, the CRDM macaroni piping, and here there could be a leakage. We have to investigate that. This is a very small space, and the device down here can go in this small space, and it goes deep into that to check whether there is a leakage. Developing such a device, and also we have to come up with a conceptual idea. This is a manipulator being developed by NEDO, and so this manipulator is to be used to move a robot forward in this small space. Now, regarding repair technology, top part and bottom part, and also hatch. And first, let me talk about the bottom area. And as I said earlier, suppression chamber is mentioned here. This is a vent pipe. And here, in the case of unit two, there could be a hole. To repair this, that's highly challenging because this is a high-level radioactive area, so it's very difficult task. So the biggest candidate right now is to use this vent pipe to stop water leakage. And above that, we create a boundary and fill the system with water. And grouting will be done here mainly. If we do grouting, it's a kind of cement, and naturally that water is flowing. And there we are going to create grouting, and usually water penetrate. So we have to make sure that water stops there. That is to say, firstly, this is an element test auxiliary material, and we create a hole there. It's like an automobile airbag mechanism. You can imagine that. And we blow it up, and grout will be inserted there precisely. That is one possible approach being developed now. And also, we have pipes here, different types of piping, SLC-related pipes there. And we have pipes down to this level. There, we have to close that. So at the bottom, quencher bottom, we are going to insert stopping water material. Grouting will be done too. So grout and boundary will be created anew, and we are collecting data for that. Having said that, water has to be stopped, leakage has to be stopped, and technologies are being developed for that. And grout has to be solidified quickly, so quickly acting grout, and also with long durability is needed. That said, 100% water stopping, we do not know if that is possible. Therefore, even if there is a waterway, and we have to create also a system to collect water. So we have to develop a system as a package of various technologies and devices. Of course, we have element technologies. However, take water stoppage example. We have various necessary technologies all together. So we have to develop a possible scenario. This is a top part. Penetration, 100 or 200 penetrations exist. For important ones, without conducting an examination, we are going to fill it with grout. And also, in small chambers, we have many, many devices. And when there is a leakage, we cannot afford to go into that room to repair because of the radiation. Therefore, for each room, we are going to fill that with water. So we are going to stop water there and submerge it.